Okay, so welcome back to the channel. This is gonna be a Vendel Swarm run in a Saber with Badger Repeaters and Rattler Rockets. Enjoy! Okay, I think both of my teammates just left. And I don't know why. Maybe because they didn't get any kills. I'm sorry, boys. Okay. So, I'm doing nothing special here, just using a standard saber. It's not a saber comment or anything. I swapped out all the guns for Badger repeaters size 2 with gimbals, and then I tried to get in close on the enemy below 2,000 or 1,000 meters, and then those are pretty effective. Just make sure you can stay on target long enough. And don't hit any asteroids and you'll be fine. Okay, this one's down. Chase them. Do not overshoot. You don't need to fly the spaceship, like keep it in the air going forward constantly. You can stop still and you can tail some enemies slowly. So things like that, what just happened, not very good because you have to readjust, find your target, and it takes a lot of time. Try to get in close and stay on the tail behind, or if the enemy comes towards you, just reverse back so you can keep track of the enemy. Also, most of the times I've died is when the Vandals ram me. So try to get out of their way when they come speeding towards you. Okay. Let's turn up the volume a little bit so you guys can hear something. This was one of the first hunters, or the first hunter. The hunters drop missiles. Missiles are great because they take a lot of time off your time to kill. Oh crap. Yeah. The missile just killed him. And then you can just pick up another missile because each hunter drops a missile, which is great. Okay, that was a scavenger, so I'm down to 7 missiles now. The Saber can hold 8 rattlers. If you can keep track of your missiles, that's great. If not, don't worry too much, it will tell you when they're empty. And also when they're full. So when you try and pick up a missile, but your missiles are full, you will see that. Guy is flying awfully close. Attempt to put an end to him. try to keep track of the position the enemy died, because they drop important stuff like fuel. You need a lot of fuel. And also the rocket and health pickups. If you can keep track of the kill position, then you can easily pick up all the drops after you've killed the other guy. And then you can focus on the next target. That's the quickest way to do it. He lost a wing there. Okay, there's the drops. Picking it up. Zero hostile contacts. Now that's the time when you want to make sure you stock up on fuel. So during the battle, don't focus on fuel so much, because you're gonna have enough. After each round, zero hostile contacts remaining. When you hear that, that's your trigger to look for fuel. Every time you kill an enemy like a hunter, make sure to grab the rocket first. And then repairs or ammunition if you use like a ballistics type gun. When they run like that, which is giving me a hard time. I like the Saber because it has good clear audio cues. All the clicks and noises you hear, they have a meaning. If you see a named enemy, it's worth spending a rocket. Because they die hard. And you want to go through this very fast normally. So just use it. Ship is a little bit damaged, so going for the wrench. The orange wrench will repair your ship, and it's all back to green now. You can see in the bottom left. It's a hunter when it comes in range, which is like 3,000. Then you can acquire a missile lock and send the missile. Usually one missile and some focused firing kills the hunters. With the scavengers you can get them by just focusing them down. But once you reach like wave 10 or something, there won't be any scavengers left. Everything will be named bosses, hunters, alphas, and stuff like that. No more scavengers. Always make sure you're within 1,000 meters. It's a lot easier to kill if you are I don't know, I think the weapon effectiveness decreases with distance, which would make sense. Also, you're more likely to hit the enemy because, yeah, distance, angles, and stuff. The nice thing about the Batcher repeaters is that they don't overheat that fast, and they have a high rate of fire, so you can kill enemies pretty fast, even though it's a size 2 gun. You just have to be close enough. Another scavenger. Hunter missile. Hunter missile. I hate when they do that. Okay, now you're done. Full, that can be changed. And he's gone. This is still full. That's the end of wave 7, I guess. Let's get some more wrenches. My hull is orange again. Sometimes it can be hard to see where the next enemy is, just because it's also orange-like, and the targeting stuff is also orange, and the arrow that points to where the enemy is orange, so you won't see it. Takes a bit of getting used to. Now this is a named boss, so it's okay to spend like 2 missiles. Just makes quick work of the enemy. Proximity alert. Pick up all the stuff. On you, hunter, you need to die now. He's a bit far. Sometimes it's good to retract the landing gear and extend it back again. This will fix some weapon issues on the Super Hornet and maybe also on the Saber. I'm not so sure about that, but there's some weird stuff going on that can be fixed by doing it, so I just do it sometimes. Where's the drop from the guy? Oh, there it is. That was close. Those vandals like to get close. Itself. Still missing one gun on the right side, I guess. Don't know how it got lost, and I don't know why I didn't get it back with all the wrenches I collected. Death coming. One of those times they're gonna ram me to death. Payday! Pay me! You gotta be careful with the wreckage, because if you're too fast and hit some leftovers from the other ship, then you're gonna die. And you probably don't want to die. Hostiles. Bring it. Whole fleet of them. That's a pretty tight space to fight in. A little bit overkill, but I want to get rid of some of those guys. Quite annoying. Okay, so it finally happened. One of them rammed me, and you can see down below that he used a neutron cannon to kill me. That's what mostly happens. Those are pretty powerful. Now this stuff from my own death that I just picked up. I got all four guns back now. I think I will save that rocket because it's the last guy of this wave. Yep. Okay. So, after all the guys are spawned, I usually press pick closest or pick closest target. That will put you to the closest enemy, which is a good way because you don't want to trigger all the enemies. That would just make it a lot harder for you to survive and kill them off. says I've killed him, but he's still going. Yeah. Now he's dead for sure. That should be the last guy from this way. So this is 14. It will be over by the end of 18. That's when 19 should start, but 19 is like the finish. Zula Fini. Got so many rockets, I'm dropping all the flares, but nothing seems to help. Oh, there's a Reaper. Pretty banged up. And another rocket. Why not? It's taking a bit longer than usual. That's just because I'm alone. There was a wrench. Is that one? No. Something else. Oh, there is one. Oh, why so many rockets? I get the feeling the more rockets I shoot, the more rockets the enemy shoots. Sounds fair though. Again, still flying. Just like the other guy before. Is red. I gotta run for a little while. Just until my shields recover. Yup. Finally popped. And the last one for wave 16. Okay, fuel is full, rockets, I don't know exactly how many I have, I lost count. But probably a few. Survived two muscles. Tough nut. But eventually everyone breaks down. Denny. Last round, Double E, Leech, Death Witch, and Voodoo. This is gonna be a fast one because I'm not gonna fuck around with them. Just kill them. Just like that. Thank you. tough one. So, we're done, and as you can see, it's not voodoo magic. That's how you earn 812 rental credits, spending 52 minutes in Vandalswarm, having a score of 232,000. One death, 97 kills. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, please leave a comment, like, click subscribe, and come back for more. Bye bye.